Tesla stated today that the company's self-driving technology will be widely available by the end of 2022. The goal is to make Tesla's FSD beta program available to all paying customers in the United States as soon as possible. For many years, Elon Musk has mentioned the end of the year, but in this case, it appears he's referring to a wide beta release rather than a finished product. Welcome to Tech Heaven, and in this video we'll take a look at Tesla's mission to widely release the FSD feature by the end of 2022. Curious to know? Let's find out! Elon Musk spoke at the 2022 Offshore Northern Shore conference in Stavanger, Norway, about a variety of topics, including Tesla's FSD wide release and renewable energy. Musk's attention is currently focused on two major projects, SpaceX's Starship program and Tesla's full self-driving technology. Starship is intended to be a rapidly reusable spacecraft that can pave the way for Mars missions, whereas FSD is Tesla's self-driving system that is expected to save countless lives on the road. The two technologies I'm focused on, ideally getting done by the end of the year, are getting our Starship into orbit and then having Tesla cars that can do self-driving, Musk said. Musk then provided a brief update on the FSD's general availability in the United States and other territories. According to the CEO, he hopes to have FSD ready by the end of the year, subject to regulatory approval. This is an ambitious goal, and Musk has already failed at it several times. Have self-driving in broad release, at least in the United States, and potentially in Europe, depending on regulatory approval, Musk stated. Tesla's FSD wide release has been elusive for years, despite Musk's optimism about the technology. However, Tesla's FSD beta program has been a success thus far, which bodes well for the technology as a whole. Since the early FSD betas, this has been one of the most anticipated updates. While some of this was due to the anticipated improvements in this beta, the other was due to the fact that it has been a while since the last update. FSD beta also appears more confident in heavy traffic, moving forward when an opportunity presents itself. After all, Tesla's FSD beta fleet now numbers around 100,000 drivers, and the system has been tested on public roads without incident thus far. Tesla's full self-driving and autopilot features have been heavily monitored. A recent campaign to ban the FSD was launched because the system was not detecting children on the road. There have also been reports of crashes while using the autopilot feature. Passengers were in the back seat in one of them, despite the fact that drivers were warned to be cautious when using the feature. The FSD package also includes the autopilot features. This is despite aggressive Tesla critics looking for any opportunity to get FSD off the road. Tesla's cease and desist letter to Dan O'Dowd of Green Hills Software and the Dawn Project is an indication of the company's growing confidence in FSD. O'Dowd has waged an aggressive campaign against Tesla and its FSD program, claiming that the technology is dangerous to people. While Tesla does not typically respond to such attacks, the company has begun efforts to halt O'Dowd's anti-FSD campaign. Tesla stated in its cease and desist letter that O'Dowd's defamatory actions are endangering customers. By the way, if you're watching us for the first time, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you can enjoy our future videos while getting updated. Getting back to the topic, these are possibly the topics Musk will cover in Master Plan Part 3, which he admitted to working on in March 2022. Some speculate that the Tesla bot will find a home in the upcoming plan penned by the CEO himself. Musk also mentioned SpaceX, Tesla, and the Boring Company in his tweet, noting that his Master Plan Part 3 would include sections about each of them. He's been tweeting about the Boring Company's success and upcoming expansion in Las Vegas. We can only speculate on what he might share about Tesla and SpaceX in the plan, but many people would be surprised if there were no details about FSD. However, this is not Musk's first announcement about self-driving cars. In 2019, he stated his intention to have 1 million robotaxis on the road by the end of the year. During a first quarter profit conference call in May, Musk stated, "Robotaxi will be highly optimized for autonomy, which means it will not have a steering wheel or pedals. There are a few other innovations that I think are quite exciting around it, but it is fundamentally optimized to achieve the lowest fully considered cost per mile or kilometer when counting everything." He recently shifted his goal of 1 million robotaxis to attracting 1 million people to Tesla's FSD software beta program. There is a critical difference between a robotaxi and the FSD program. A robo-taxi can operate without a driver, whereas FSD requires a human driver to be alert and ready to take control at any time. Musk stated that the price of FSD software in North America would rise to $15,000 this month. FSD is also available by subscription for $199 per month, but Musk made no mention of any price changes. It was also unclear whether the price increases would be spread across global markets. This is the second increase in FSD prices this year, following a jump from $10,000 to $12,000 in January. The current FSD provides auto lane changes, navigation on autopilot, auto park, and smart summon, which allows drivers to call the car and have it drive itself to their location without the need for a driver. The car can detect and react to traffic signals thanks to traffic light and stop sign control. Despite technological advances, Tesla's FSD does not allow its vehicles to be fully autonomous. Musk also stated that the world needed more oil and gas right now to deal with the energy shortage while also using sustainable energy sources. Realistically, I think we need to use gas and oil in the short term because otherwise civilization will crumble, Musk said on the sidelines of the conference. One of the world's greatest challenges has been the transition to sustainable energy and a sustainable economy, which will take decades to complete. Musk's remarks come as Europe faces its worst energy crisis in decades. Russia cut off gas exports to several European countries, including Poland, Bulgaria, and Finland, because they refused to pay in rubles, as the Kremlin demanded in March. The main Russia-Germany pipeline, Nord Stream 1, is only operating at 20% capacity due to technical issues, according to Russian exporter Gazprom. As a result, countries such as Germany are scrambling to stock up on gas for the winter. And the European Union has launched a campaign to reduce gas consumption by 15% during the cold months. Musk responded to a question about whether Norway should continue to drill for oil and gas, saying, "I believe some additional exploration is warranted at this time." And this is probably not the first time that the CEO has stated his concerns regarding oil and gas issue. Offshore wind power production in the North Sea combined with stationary battery packs, he thinks, could become a significant source of energy. In the winter, it could provide a strong sustainable energy source, he said. While not all Tesla drivers are to blame for mishandling the full self-driving feature, a considerable number are. As a result of several incidents, the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration investigated the autopilot feature. With all of the bugs, it's clear that it is still in beta. More drivers would help Tesla in identifying problems, but it would also mean more vehicles on the road, potentially leading to more accidents. Musk is also known for stating goals that contradict those of the companies for which he works. So this could be his vision for the FSD. He's overly optimistic about his projects and timelines. It's the reason for the Cybertruck's numerous delays. Musk announces a release date before the product is ready. Owners of Tesla vehicles will have to wait and see if the company follows through. And with that being said, it's time to end our video. But before that, we'd like to know your thoughts about the FSD feature. Have you ever tried it? Let us know in the comments. Like this video and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos like this. We'll see you in the next video.